approaching Canley.
The coldest of all time. He's in.
Please mind the gap when leaving the train.
Hey, this is the wave now, man. At the matte black, swagger like the Rat Pack, jacket no snapback. Nah, I don't have Snapchat, I'm not easy to contact, I'm old school like that. She real cheeky with the back chat, yeah you took a good one, let's see if you can back that. She left no room to backtrack, you should see my room, bathing, fat cat. In fact, if you skip the chit chat, we can beat the traffic, I'll get you back.
Unfortunately, some of the audio for these clips got more shagged than Mia Malkova, so I'm going to have to be narrating over them for the purposes of this little journey. Right here, if I had to guess what I was thinking or talking about, it's got to be somewhat relating to the fact that I made a promise to myself never to enter a place like Birmingham, and my surprise at having to break said rules. We didn't really get to have the warm welcome that I was hoping for. I was hoping to really get the chance to get to know the players initially, but as we'd arrived, they're actually already into their first game of the day. The structure of the tournament, the way it worked, was that you had to play multiple seeding games on the first day, and it would kind of seed you in for that knockout phase. So they were deep up against one of the toughest teams in the tournament, the UK Painkillers. And let's just say it didn't necessarily end up going our way. Ironically, our former Ruddy man in the mid lane, Ketsuo, had a lot to say on his Vladimir, and it led us towards a rather tumultuous defeat. But there was nothing to fear. I was sure if me, the gaffer, the Alex Ferguson of Ruddy, was able to talk to these young men, we'd be able to turn it around on the first day. But then I realised that I was a fat and self-centred individual. So instead of sticking around to watch the second game, I went to go get some food with Regan.
What are you saying, my little son? I bought my little son some milkshake for himself. How's your day going so far?
A little bit nervous for the team. Game one lost.
They're playing against the Army now.
Let me just remind the camera. When it came to getting you here, I definitely fathered you all the way here.
Bombocard!
This silly little idiot, man. I might have to take him on Jeremy Carl just to prove to him I'm his dad.
You are the father.
We're up against the British Army right now. What are you saying about the British Army?
I think it's very technical. If things go south, I'm going to have to get a front line.
Yeah. their front line must be mad.
There's a couple guys dressed in camo that are going to get taken out.
Nah, they're in ghillie. They've got different chromas over there, boy.
Leaving the lads to do their own thing actually turned out to be a pretty good decision, because as you can see here, we absolutely smoked off the British Army. But still, I wasn't satisfied. We'd been to the op block jungle in Equalize, no rumble, but still, I craved more action.
We're here at NEC right now. We just played against the British Army in the League of Legends tournament. We smoked them off. You know, the front line got a little bit disheveled. They asked me to come and watch the game. Tried to get me to sit down. That's how they get you, man. One minute you're sitting down, next minute you're in Iraq.
Nah, it's dangerous over them sides, I promise you, family. We had one guy come to the event with us, his name's William. I hope he's doing alright, but he went over to the army booth, he put on one of them VR headsets. It was like he was in the beginning of Skyrim. He's in the back of a van in Kabul going 50 down the M-way. John's next to him screaming, "I miss my wife back at home." He's thinking, "Where? And when am I going to go home, man?" Yeah, haven't seen him since, man, but I hope he's doing well. After all this tomfoolery had subsided, I realised it was time to resume my role as the gaffer of Ruddy Esports, and I decided to go for a little interview with my main man, Trizzy Mizzy.
No, but the British Army, they've got a whole booth here, obviously. What do you feel like when you come here? You see Bear Man and Ghillie suits coming like they're on one different camo chroma. Like, it's a bit insidious, no?
It's something like that.
It's like when you're just trying to watch, like, a man's just trying to watch the boss on Twitch or something, and I'm just getting bare Navy ads, like.
Sure. I was born in Bilgewater, but I was made in the Royal Navy.
Have you seen me? Do I look like I leave my yard? You're asking me to go and look in submarines like I'm fucking John Lennon from the Beatles, bro. What's going on, man? I'm not going to fix anything. I can't even fix my mental health, bro.
It was always a pleasure to interview my main man, Trizzy Mizzy, but now we were into the fray and up against Into the Breach for our next match. They brought a big sponsor, a big team, and some big players in regards to Snuggly, you sir, and your main man on screen right now, Horrid Henry's brother. They'd done it in the UKLC before, but could they do it on a cold night in Birmingham against Ruddy FC? The answer for us? Fortunately, absolutely not. And in 30 minutes, we absolutely blew the backs out of Into the Breach. And this made me and Regan both very, very happy chappies. With our games for the day concluded, it was time to get down the pub and let the antics really begin. But not before a quick recap.
Day one. Three W's. One L.
End of day one, little TLDR. We finished second seed in our group. Only dropping a game to the UK Painkillers, which, you know, obviously dropped a game to a former Ruddy man himself. It's like when Sol Campbell switched sides, man. It's really sad.
Switching sides, how many times?
Switching sides, how many times? How many times have I crashed man down in the movies?
To be honest with you, I think we'd already gotten a little bit weighed by this point, so instead of recapping, the bars just took over.
Link Up TV, Link Up TV. Behind bars, behind bars.
You say no more, listen. Insomnia day one.
Ad libs.
I told him, let me hit out the pay gun.
Nah, this guy thinks he's a yardie, man.
I can climb up the ladder. If it hit the matter, I tell the flipping internet geeks, suck your ah. When I'm in Jamaica, smoke weed with grabber, have a fat sitting yell waiting called Natasha.
The name's Ray Gun.
But I'm not from the box like Ray Gun.
Leaving man dead. No zombies.
Ish.
Ray Gun. Kino.
Yeah. The Totem.
The Totem.
See the see the spliffs I'm smoking.
You gotta let me speak, man. Bars. Potent. Do I spit with the flow then? I show them.
Listen.
Crescendo like sonar in the moment.
Nah, listen, bad the way I'm behaving. I got lost in the ends like Shamima Begum.
As we got down the hallway, we realised we could see young Trizzy Mizzy getting busy in the dizzy distance. And we realised that things are about to get technical at the Wetherspoons.
Oh. Man like Twizwa Mizwa, it's the return of the Mac. Mizzy or Mac, on the attack. You know, I was a DJ on the inside, but now like Ellie Goulding, now I'm on the outside.
This man with the references, this is nuts.
We say little Witherspoons thing, man like Rhythm here as well. Two boys, 40% of Ruddy. That's a big percentage. GCSE maths taught me enough.
Your name's Rhythm. I'm yet to see you on the Rhythm. What's going on?
On the Rhythm?
Yeah, on the Rhythm. Where's the bars? Where's the bars?
I ain't got no bars.
I can tell you got bars. You got that?
Huh? Maybe if we win. Maybe if
you got that Luther Vandross trim. Where's the little peach fuzz. What are you saying about the waves? Because I know you're a jungler, because obviously you know wave states and that. So you see like
that's the bright side, you know what I mean?
Yeah, little twists.
Right over here is the Kindred OTP. Pan the camera so the youths can see.
Ooh.
If it don't get banned B1, then it's getting banned B3.
Ooh, ish.
If you step on that with an R1, R2, guaranteed your whole crew getting done up in like 1-2 minutes.
Nah, you gotta see his players on Kindred. You gotta peep those. I swear he's got more marks than Peep Show.
Ooh!
Reload it!
Hang on.
I don't know about that. You can ban the Kindred, it'll still come clean. Guarantee it's an FF15 when I see my G doing his
team.
Listen.
Durag on and the dragon's gone.
Let him see the do-rag,
Inspection, inspection.
Oh, it's cold. Inspect the hairline.
Take it off.
Do-rag off. Take it off.
Don't let them see my hairline, no. Show them yours. Ish. Factual, freeze frame. Luangel. I got angles like Di Maria. In the distance.
The antics for day one were always going to be somewhat limited. The reality was we had a job to do and we were going to do it properly. So me and Regan decided to go back to the Airbnb and I waxed his batty nicely. Unfortunately, I won't be showing you, man, that. That's just for us to see. Join us next time for our day two.
When you call me back. last in the week. One freestyle, the career last in the week. You don't talk.